want to start with my favorite buddy, Mr. Credibility himself. No, folks, he's not racist at all. I can't even say that with a straight face. I'm talking, of course, about Tucker, the white supremacist Carlson, KKK Tucker, as I like to call him. Look, this is a guy who has a history of saying blatantly false lies and divisive comments, misogynistic comments. He's the one just days after the Texas El Paso shooting where 22 people died at the hands of a white supremacist. Then Tucker goes on his show and he says the idea of white supremacy is a hoax. The only advertiser since then that has stayed with him, not to be surprised, is Mike Lindell from MyPillow. A lot of these other advertisers have jumped ship because of Tucker Carlson's horrendous comments he said over the years. Does he have ratings? Absolutely. But he also has a lot of lies, and people like that. I guess people like that right-wing conspiracy theory stuff. You know, otherwise, we wouldn't even know what the word InfoWars meant. But Tucker Carlson now has taken it to a whole nother level. I've been telling you this for years of being on the radio, that Tucker is a blatant lying fraud. And this example over the course of the last 24 hours is the perfect example to prove that to you. It's very, very simple, ladies and gentlemen. Tucker Carlson has been telling viewers for the last week that he had some very important papers that prove that Hunter Biden and Joe Biden broke laws and that this paperwork could end the presidency for Joe Biden. He's been saying that he had this source that has these damning documents, and that Carlson's producer shipped the documents across the country with a brand name company as the mail carrier. But oh my gosh, you're not going to believe this, ladies and gentlemen. The excuse that Tucker Carlson is saying for the reason why he wasn't able to share the documents with you on the air. You're not going to believe it, ladies and gentlemen. We have the audio to prove it for you. This is very funny. And I'll tell you what, if a 10-year-old showed up in class and said, "Teacher, I didn't do my homework because my dog ate it," that would probably be a better excuse than this one. And by the way, I'm not joking. Having a listen to what happened to Tucker Carlson's exclusive documents that would have gotten the Bidens. Have a listen to this.
There's a lot going on that we don't have time to get to on the air, but there's something specific going on behind the scenes right now that we did feel we should tell you about. So on Monday of this week, we received from a source, a collection of confidential documents related to the Biden family. We believe those documents are authentic, they're real, and they're damning. At the time we received them, my executive producer, Justin Wells, and I were in Los Angeles preparing to interview Tony Bobulinski about the Bidens' business dealings in China, Ukraine, and other countries. So we texted a producer in New York, and we asked him to send those documents to us in LA, and he did that. So Monday afternoon of this week, he shipped those documents overnight to California with a large national carrier, a brand name company that we've used, you've used countless times with never a single problem. But the Biden documents never arrived in Los Angeles.
Oh, boy. Well, that's terrible. Hey, Tucker, did anybody make a copy of those documents? Did you tell them to fax you the documents or send you a cell phone picture of the documents? You're claiming that this source had the most damning documents on earth that could pin the Bidens. I would imagine that's worth millions and millions of dollars to some people. And you decided that no copies were made, and we just sent it through regular mail as if somebody was mailing somebody like a basketball or I don't know. Maybe somebody, you know, just kind of like how somebody would mail somebody a love letter. Interesting. He goes on with the excuse. Now, have a listen. Have a listen to what happened to his documents. It gets better.
Tuesday morning, we received word from the shipping company that our package had been opened and the contents were missing. Mm. The documents had disappeared.
Wow.
Now, to its credit, the company took this very seriously and immediately began a search.
I'm sure they did.
They traced the envelope from the moment our producers dropped it off in Manhattan on Monday all the way to 3:44 a.m. yesterday morning.
Wow.
That's when an employee at a sorting facility in another state noticed that our package was open and empty. Ooh. Apparently, it had been opened.
Oh.
So the company's security team interviewed every one of its employees who touched the envelope we sent.
Wow.
They searched the plane and the trucks that carried it. They went through the office in New York where our producer dropped that package off. They combed the entire cavernous sorting facility. They used pictures of what we had sent so that searchers would know what to look for. They went far and beyond.
Wow.
But they found nothing.
Wow. What an investigation. They found nothing. Well, apparently, though, they learned that this envelope with these documents, it was wide open. I mean, they were able to find out that information.
Knock, knock, FBI.
Wow, it must have been a Democrat. It must have been George Soros that somehow intercepted this envelope. Wow, a full-on investigation. Oh, no, folks, it gets better. It gets better. Have a listen to the rest of what Tucker said about the dog ate his homework. Have a listen to this.
Those documents have vanished. As of tonight, the company has no idea and no working theory even about what happened to this trove of materials, documents that are directly relevant to the presidential campaign just 6 days from now. We spoke to executives at that company a few hours ago. They seemed baffled and deeply bothered by this.
Yeah, I bet
they
were.
And so are we.
Okay, is there anybody on planet Earth with a brain that believes that Tucker Carlson is telling the truth? Is this the dumbest thing, egg on your face? Let me tell you what really happened, ladies and gentlemen. For those of you that might be a little bit confused, Tucker Carlson opened up his mouth and said he had a source with these unbelievably damning documents that were going to prove that the Bidens are criminals. You know what happened yesterday, folks? I'll tell you what happened. He got word that these documents were not verified, and he couldn't verify these documents, and they probably were false. They were just lies, but he couldn't say that on the air because it made him look bad. But something that makes him look just as bad, if not worse, is he come up with this grand scheme that somehow these documents were lost in the mail. That's right. That's what happened, ladies and gentlemen. Tucker is so easy to figure out. They found out that these documents had zero credibility and that if they read them on the air, they could probably get sued because they were blatant lies. He couldn't say that on the air because it would have made him look horrible, but he did the next best thing that also makes him look horrible and came up with a lie that it was lost in the mail. Ladies and gentlemen, hypothetically speaking, if I told you right now that I had documents that would prove that the Bidens are criminals beyond the shadow of a doubt, that would be worth millions and millions of dollars to somebody to buy the rights to that. You mean to tell me that the source that sent those documents through the mail sent the original copies, nobody made a copy of it, nobody decided to fax it, they decided to just trust the mail company to mail it to Tucker, and oh my God, they were lost, the documents just vanished, and they're missing. Ladies and gentlemen, Tucker Carlson is a biased buffoon, and he is a blatant liar. That is exactly what he is. Let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. I'll tell you one thing that Tucker has not lost. His Klan outfit that is probably sitting in his closet right now. That certainly wasn't lost when he probably bought that through the mail. But all of a sudden, these documents are lost. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a lie. Tucker Carlson is a blatant liar. He is a fool. And for people out there that think that anything this guy says on Fox News on a nightly basis has any credibility, you are also a fool. They have egg on their face. It was just recently that they found out that their writer, their longtime writer for over a decade, was an evil white supremacist. The lead writer of the show was saying horrendous white supremacist-like Klan things on the internet for years, right underneath their nose. This is the same man that has said blatantly racist and misogynistic comments, and now, ladies and gentlemen, he is caught once again in a lie, and this is an embarrassment.